cardiovascular disease is the number one killer of Americans. And what we're trying to understand is, for the recreational surfer, is this a strong enough stimulus to their cardiovascular system that'll reduce their risk for cardiovascular diseases later in life? So we go to the field, we bring the surfers into the field at the beach, and basically we have them surf. And while they're surfing, we're monitoring their activity with cameras. And we're also, they also wear a heart rate monitor at the same time. After they finish their surfing activity, we bring those videos that we've taken at the beach of them surfing and the heart rate data into the laboratory, and we synchronize the heart rates to the activities.
I was interested to find out, you know, how I matched up to other surfers and what I compared to and how many waves you ride. You know, I had always assumed that paddling out and duck diving under waves was where you spent most of your energy, but then it seemed like catching the wave was really where I'm putting in the most effort, so that was interesting.
So what we're doing is we're using the Biodex, and it's an isokinetic dynamometer, and it calculates your leg strength. And so basically what we're doing with that is testing if leg strength has anything to do with how you stand on a surfboard.
The studies really helped me translate what I'm learning in the classroom and applying it to something. And when you apply it to something that you love to do, it really reinforces your kind of passions. This is so interesting for me is because it's something that I really enjoy doing in my daily life. And to find out that it also could potentially have benefits for my health at the same time is great.
So one of the things we're looking at now, is there a difference in paddling mechanics when someone is using a wetsuit versus no wetsuit? So how much does that change how someone paddles? Do they fatigue faster? Are they more prone to injury if they're changing how they're paddling? Are they less efficient? Are they using more energy?
The information we'd like to get to the surfer in the future is we would like to be able to tell them that participating in surfing is an exercise that is going to reduce your risk for future disease, or in chronic diseases such as cardiovascular diseases.
Super exciting to hear about the University Student Union and just to walk in the feel that it gives you. And it's a culture shift for our campus. It's a huge milestone that we are now able to have a University Student Union. And it feels that now we're able to bring all of our students together and have those formal interactions that are outside of the classroom that complements the learning.
The USU has so much to offer, from game room to going to orientation and having their own little space there, to the Gender Equity Center, to LGBTQ Pride Center. You go in there, every single space has a welcoming environment. Everywhere you go, you will have a student come up to you and say, hey, how are you doing? Do you want to get involved in this? Are you interested in doing this? Finding your passion, in a sense, for Cal State San Marcos is what you find wherever you go.
I just feel like I'm at home. Like, I feel really relaxed and I feel comfort. I feel like this place is a space to hang out with friends and like connect and just laugh and enjoy your time on campus.
What I love about the Union is that it's just a place where everybody just comes together. I mean, there's like a bunch of friends I see all the time, and just food, and just a place to hang out. And I love how like all the events are gonna be thrown here, and all the events already thrown here is also great.
So the University Student Union is the heartbeat of the campus. It's the place where everyone gathers, and it's just exciting. It's exciting to see all of it unfold.
Our goal is to try to introduce more hands-on science for elementary school children. And the way that we decided to do that was to introduce college students into elementary schools and have them develop and deliver hands-on science lessons that are standards-based. The STEM Service Learning Project allows students from several different courses here at Cal State San Marcos to independently create and deliver hands-on science lessons to our local elementary school children, allowing them the opportunity to experience science in a one-hour fashion and benefiting the teachers as well.
This program and finding myself as I started college and discovering how much I really loved science and how good I can be at it really got me inspired to show others that they can be good as well.
We really looked to Cal State San Marcos for help, and I'm a former biology teacher, so science is always on my mind, and we knew that we always want to be able to provide as many hands-on opportunities for students to engage in science and interact in science. And so when we were able to work with Cal State San Marcos to bring this program, I thought it was a win-win for everyone.
In finding this program and seeing that I can come to, you know, elementary schools and get people, kids, excited about science made me excited. And in doing that, I discovered a new passion in teaching science, not only loving it, but teaching it as well.
Just in our state alone, there's a gigantic need to develop dual language programs. And so they are looking at our office, our School of Education, to provide professional development for teachers. And there aren't any other training facilities for these types of teachers. In the School of Education, we develop a dual language certificate program that is offered at Cal State San Marcos.
Our dual language program is a two-way immersion program. So we're trying to build fluency in two different languages among two different types of students. We want students to become bilingual, biliterate, and we want them to have cross-cultural competence. Our testing data would demonstrate that the students who are in our dual immersion program succeed academically at rates higher than those who are in the English-only program. So the more students we can get into the dual language program, the better.
Really, in today's day and age, being bilingual is a huge advantage for students. I actually grew up myself in a bilingual program, and that's what led me to do my study abroad in college and pursue, you know, international business. My passion was with teaching, so I came back to teaching, and the only place I wanted to teach was a dual language program where it provides those same opportunities for students.
A typical day in our classroom would be starting off into our groups, and then we split it 50-50 into English and Spanish, which is great because if you don't get it the first time, you can always get it the second time.
I think having that mindset where you can easily transfer your ideas, if something's easier to say in Spanish than it is to come across in English, then you have that extended vocabulary in another language that helps you get your feeling and your message across.
So I really look towards Cal State San Marcos as a resource for us in the future to fill our needs for highly qualified teachers.
Being a graduate of Cal State San Marcos School of Education and the Bilingual Authorization Program really prepared me to begin my journey as an educator. I graduated from my teaching credential understanding what it meant to be an educator. Today I'm able to apply the strategies that I learned during my credential program to better assist the students that I teach, and especially students that participate in a dual language program.
These students, they can be ready for the 21st century, they can be ready for the workforce. These are students that would be able to navigate various diversities linguistically or culturally. I'm so glad Cal State San Marcos is taking the step forward to bring us into what we need for the next few generations.
my name is Mike Redmond. I'm one of the classroom teachers here at the San Marcos Adult Transition Program. Now, this program is really beneficial to our students. They've all finished high school. Now they just need a little help getting on to whatever's next for them. That might be spending time at Palomar College, looking at vocational skills, or just learning how to get around better in their community.
The Adult Transition Program is for students 18 through 22 who usually have graduated out of a high school, and this program is available to them if they choose or if their parents choose.
The goal of transition programs is to help the students become as independent as possible, and that really expands beyond the traditional walls of a classroom. So students are out in the community, they learn work and vocational skills, they get ready for employment or obtain a job, they learn how to function in their community and get around as independently as possible. Many of them also learn daily living or domestic kinds of skills that they may need to be more independent. So it's just really a very different look at educational services.
They can learn how to cook and clean, and they'll learn job skills. They'll go out every day for about 6 hours a day, out into the community. They're learning how to use public transportation. They learn so much in that program. So when they're in high school, there's a lot of academics and they do electives. But when they're in the transition program, it's all about preparing them for adult life so that they can be as independent as possible and as self-sufficient as possible.
They gain life skills. Many of them may not know how to access the bus lines around here. That's one of the things we work on. They gain social skills by spending time with same age peers over at Palomar College or Cal State College, or just wherever we go in the community, it's great for them to be out and about.
How we found out about the program is through its high school teacher, Ms. Cook, at Mission Hills High School. She told us about this program, the Adult Transition Program. From there, we came and sat down with some of the staff and began the process for him to start. He's beginning to understand the value of money by going shopping with the staff and his peers here. He makes different meals at home now. He usually would just want something, just say a cheeseburger. Now he makes his own sandwiches. He's helping out with chores around the house even more now, and I'm seeing him become a lot more self-sufficient when it comes to different things.
That you're looking at a population of students and citizens in their community that are really an untapped resource. Students and people who are very committed and wanting to be employed, and are people that will not take unwanted breaks, will be there on time, will stay and work really hard, and they are so desirous of a job and desiring employment that they will be very committed and be a really good employee, very dependable and trustworthy, and just, they're really an untapped resource that most people are not aware of.
My name's Diane Wheeler. I'm the local franchise owner here in San Marcos. Casey started with us shortly after we opened. Karen Thompson from San Marcos High School Workability Program contacted me to see if I'd be interested in working with the program. She brought Casey in to meet me, and instantly we could see that Casey had a real natural ability with dogs, and so we did hire her as part of the program, which lasted about 2 months. After her 2 months in the program, we actually hired her as an employee, and she's been here since right after we opened in 2008.
And then I go in the back in the kitchen, I put my stuff down there, and after I clock in, I go wake up the dogs, these dogs. It's a fun job.
I've worked with Casey for 2 years as well, and Casey's a great worker. She does awesome. She plays with the dogs tons. She always is very active with them, running around, and they all love her. She's a really great worker. She learns really quickly, does everything that, you know, we need her to do. Yeah, it's been a really great experience. Highly recommend it, definitely. I think it's really great that these individuals get the opportunity to, you know, do what they really love, and that businesses are willing to give these students the opportunity to do that kind of thing. I've seen Casey blossom in so many ways.
Their duties are typically the same as any other employee, so they're interacting, playing with the dogs, making sure the group stays safe and there's not any issues. So if you notice two dogs that are not getting along, sometimes we'll have to separate them. They clean up after the dogs, which is a lot of work. Casey is amazing if you ever watch, because we have webcams. She never stops from the moment she gets there till the time she goes home, petting and interacting with each and every dog.
It's a really great opportunity, I think, for them and the businesses, definitely.
I think, first of all, getting involved in the community is really important for any small business. And the students, most of the students I've had have been amazing. You know, when they find their niche, and like Casey has here at Dogtopia, like Joshua has here at Dogtopia, they're excellent employees, and I wouldn't trade them for anybody else.